Hey everyone, my name is Brooke Southall. Some of y'all already know me as Biscuit. And the company I work for is Drill Team Dynamics. I am a Drill Team Dynamics associate. And why I am making these videos is to help those who are currently going through some experience that I've had in high school, to help them push through it, and to help prevent those from going through the same experiences that I had to go through, because it was not fun. But with that being said, we're going to be talking about my freshman year. It was the year that you're out of eighth grade, you're finally in high school, you know. And fun fact, when I was in eighth grade, I actually played for our high school soccer team. And I played soccer for 9 years previously, and I was initially going to play soccer. But when I joined ROTC, our instructor had mentioned that he was going to have a drill meeting after school. And I was like, well, what's drill, you know? And so I decided to stay after school, you know, kind of see what it's about. And when I stayed after school, our instructor introduced what it was. And then you heard this really loud noise in the background. Everybody turned their heads, and it was a girl who was yelling really loudly, but in a super, super cool, intense way. They marched in with such precision that they held herself with a lot of character. She had said, take seats. They all sat down in the same exact way. And when the RN team came in, they marched in and they took their seats and whatnot. And I mean, it was super, super cool to see both the unarmed team and the armed team come in. Great way to help, like, recruit first-year cadets, because that's how I get recruited. I thought it was super cool. I signed up and our first practice started. We were doing rotations. When we were split off into our rotations, we were split into four different groups. And with the four different groups, we had advanced cadets from the unarmed team teaching the first years. And the second years were also included in those groups. The reason the unarmed team was teaching was because they were more so experts in sharpness and in precision than the armed team was at the time. And whenever one of the coaches would say, rotate, everyone else would scream rotate, and so then we'd have to go to the next person. We'd have to grab our water bottles, and we'd have to set them along the wall a certain way. And the certain way we had to set it was, we had tiles on the floor, and so each person had to set their water bottle on that line where the tile was. Because whenever you went to competition, you wanted to set your water bottles down the same. You wanted to make sure everything was done the same way to make you stand out. We went to a different advanced cadet to teach us. The reason they did that was every person had a different style of teaching. Some people learn differently or better with someone else. Because for me, I personally had, there was only one advanced girl that could teach me. Because she was super patient with me, and for some reason, whatever she would say to me would click in my head. Whenever another advanced girl would try to teach me something, my brain just stopped and I couldn't do it for some reason. It was really, really weird, but that's just how my brain worked. And some of the other girls would learn way quicker than I would, and so they would do better with maybe another advanced cadet teaching them. So you have to find that medium for certain people. We did a couple weeks of those rotations and getting to know the basics. The guys would sit on one wall while the girls would sit on the other wall, and we would end our practice there. And then once those 2 to 3 weeks were up of the basic regulation movements that we were learning, they split us up into unarmed and armed. And with unarmed and armed, we didn't see the guys didn't see us, and we had really hard practices with our coach. She was a perfectionist, everything had to be perfect, and I'm the same way. I'm a perfectionist, I like to perfect it before I move on to something. And so whenever practice came around, we barely had water breaks. You'd always have to be really, really quick, and during those water breaks, you want to make sure that you're having positive talks and you're not talking negatively about someone else on the team, because that's when the talking comes up. So you want to make sure that you're making sure that those talks are positive and that no one speaking negatively of someone. Because that's when the big old drama, the D word, comes out, okay? We don't want that happening. But that's kind of how my freshman year went, is during those breaks, people would talk, and then after the breaks were up, we come right back together, and we start drilling, and it wasn't very good. Our team was pretty much based off of drilling off of anger, off of one another. So if somebody talked very poorly of another girl on the team, then what would happen is that girl would find out, and then they'd both get mad at each other, but they weren't allowed to hash it out at practice, so they had to leave it outside of the drill floor. When we left it outside of the drill floor, for some reason, whenever we were mad or angry or frustrated with someone, we drilled harder and we drilled better. Is that the best way to do it? Probably not. But the fact of the matter is, we did drill better. I would not recommend doing it on purpose because it's not good. Not fun. Through my experience, it is not fun. So when it came to them teaching us exhibition, personally, I was not great at exhibition, but I still was on exhibition. And when it came to learning, it took me forever to learn a move. It was super, super sad. Like, I would mess up, and then I'd get frustrated with myself, and then my head would just be spiraling. It was just bad. I am not great at exhibition, I will say that. Because in X, for some reason, I like to stick my neck out. Why? I don't know. I have to constantly remind myself to tuck it back and, like, keep my chin up, but tuck it back in a certain way to where my neck won't be sticking out there like it normally is. There was one day, and this is why you need to be at practice. You need to be at practice. There was 2 days where I was not there. Normal practice days, like 2-hour practice days. I was not there. I was unable to be there. And I came back the next day, and I missed so much. So much through exhibition. And keeping in mind that I'm not good at exhibition, if I messed up, my brain hurts so bad. When that happened, it was a long day for me, let me tell you. Because the next day was our 8-6 practice, and we were still doing exhibition routine stuff. And one of the girls that was better at teaching me, that I could understand from her, we had to go in the little front area of the gym that we were in, and she had to teach me everything that I missed. And it took us, and I had to learn this stuff pretty quickly so that way I could catch up with everybody else. So it was really frustrating. And then by the time I got taught everything, they just threw me in there and I had to just do it. And I kept forgetting everything because I just learned it. And I got so frustrated that I started bawling because I kept messing up and I was so upset with myself. And I just started bawling, and then my coach, she just looked at me, she was like, go sit down. And so I sat down, and I just started crying, and then I took some water, I pretty much calmed myself down, put myself back together, and I just got back in there and pushed through the rest of the day the best that I could. This is why you need to be at practice. Always be at practice. You need to be at practice, or else you're gonna miss out on some important stuff. Like I did, and being behind is not fun at all. Not at all. So always be at practice. Don't miss a practice. During one of our long 8-6 practices, we had drill team dynamics come in, and they were helping us like clean up our exhibition routine, and as well as basically showing us how to shine our shoes and doing all these other cool stuff to help us be better. During this practice, towards the end of the day, we were doing our exhibition routine, and we were in our ripple line, and we were all down at a back parade. When we were there, there was this long pause. During that long pause, we were all kind of confused, but when it came to that, the DTD members came in and put bows in our ponytails, our Coach said, okay, so whenever y'all go for your next movement, instead of saying the school name, you're going to say the team name. And that meant that we earned that name. That meant that we all earned that title. It was super, super rewarding. Majority of the girls were crying through the rest of the exhibition routine. We were all so happy that we finally got to all make it and earn this title. And it was just really rewarding as a family. As time went on, we also did have team bonding. Basically, I had invited all the girls to come over for my birthday. But my birthday is on spring break. And so when spring break came around, it was kind of difficult to have everybody over. But some of the girls came and we had a fun time. Whenever you do a team bonding, I do recommend you invite every single person on the team. Even if you think they're not going to come, invite them. Because if you don't include them, then they're going to feel left out. And then that's when conflict stirs up. And we don't want that to happen. So make sure you invite every girl on the team. Or every guy. However it is, make sure you invite everyone. If you invite one guy, invite all the guys. If you invite one girl, you invite all the girls. That's how it is. There was also another time where all the girls spent the night at another girl's house. And I was the first one to go to sleep because my sleep is very important to me. I'm always the first one to go to sleep, no matter what. Basically, a lot of stuff happened after I fell asleep. I did not know what it was. Nor did I really care, in a sense, because none of it was about me. So, you know. A lot of weird things happened. But, you know, teenage girls. Basically, everybody was sleeping everywhere in the house. Like, it was kind of funny. And the next day, we all had some more fun, and then we all kind of went home. And the next day we had practice and all that good stuff. So I mean, team bonding is good. Just make sure that you're speaking positively of your fellow teammates, because they are your family. You're going to be stuck with them for the rest of the year. So you want to be nice to them. Do not say anything negative about someone else. It's not rewarding at all. Make sure you keep your conversations positive. The thing that would happen during our practices would be our coach would say, first years know nothing. Freshmen know nothing. That was really, as a freshman on a team, you can understand why she would say freshmen know nothing, because we're new. We're new. You know, that's totally valid. But when it came to, saying first years on the team as, a sophomore, it kind of hurt them when you would say freshmen know nothing, because they were a sophomore in high school, that's kind of not cool because they just got past freshman year. It really would be more beneficial to say first years know nothing, but when I say this, I do not recommend it. Because, yes, first years on the team don't really know anything about drill, but when it comes to creativity for exhibition, if you teach them a certain way of doing exhibition and say, hey, I need you to go come up with something, majority of the freshmen or the first years on the team are not going to know what to do. Because when I was taught a certain way. And so whenever I drill based off of what I was taught. And I wasn't really allowed to have that creativity when it came to exhibition routines and whatnot and coming up with new moves. My space was very limited. And when you have a bunch of first years come on the team, that's where your ideas come from. So there is a benefit to it, to where you can get more stuff done when you say first years know nothing, but there is a downside to it when it comes to creativity and trying to come up with new things. So you want to try and find that balance in between. I know I struggled with trying to find that balance throughout my years in JROTC, but you got to find a happy medium in between it. We did go through that my freshman year of just complete year of first years know nothing. I just did what I was told, basically. We had days for practice where basically it'd be canceled, due to weather or, say, one of the instructors had to leave early for the day, something. Something would happen where practice would be canceled. When practice was canceled, it was a relief because we didn't have to, work our bodies as hard and do our homework, right when we got home, you know. But at the end of the day, when we rode the bus home or we had our parents come and pick us up early, it was like, it was super, super weird. Because we were so used to having practice every single day after school from 3:35 to 6 at night. Like, that's how we did it every single day. We were so used to those long practices and having that day off, it was just super weird. When you have practice canceled or something like that, it is a good time for you to study your inspection questions and for you to get your homework done. Typically, whenever I got home, I had about 2 hours, and as you know, my sleep is very important to me, and then I had to sleep. Because by the time I got home, first thing I did was eat dinner, and then I showered, and then right after I showered was when I did my homework. And eating dinner and taking a shower probably took me an hour, so I had about an hour or two to do my homework before I, like, knocked out. Because I would wake up at like 5-6 o'clock the next morning. With those 2 extra hours, that gave me more time to get my homework done and study my inspection questions. So you gotta use your time wisely. Use it wisely. So this is my part one of my freshman year. So make sure you stay tuned with my channel because I will be posting part two next Monday, as well as the following weeks to come. I will be posting my sophomore, junior, and senior year into parts. So make sure you keep checking on the channel every Monday, and if you have any questions, comments, or concerns, leave them in the comments down below, and I will try and answer any questions you have to the best of my ability. So stay positive, stay safe, have a wonderful day, love yourself, bye!